But even without any competitions, Gould's career continued to advance. He gave one concert after another, among them, in 1946 and 47, his first appearances with an orchestra, where he played Beethoven's Piano Concerto No. 4.
Unfortunately, the young artist showed some incipient mannerisms and limited his self-control to the periods when he himself was playing. As he approaches adult status, he will undoubtedly learn to suppress his disturbing fidgeting while his collaborators are at work.
A subject that the press was to spend the next 17 or 18 years returning to, until Gould stopped appearing in public completely. Just like his habit of singing along noisily and his unconventional, casual outfit.
I happen to like casual clothes, and I rarely wear tails at my recitals. And yes, it's true, I take my shoes off to rehearse, and sometimes my shirt hangs out of my trousers and I don't notice. Incidentally, this was all part of a game. At that age, luckily, one doesn't have the least idea of the responsibility involved in giving a concert.
In 1947, the agent Walter Homburger began to manage Gould's concerts, whose frequency increased at the same steady speed as his repertoire. In addition to works by Couperin, Scarlatti, Czerny, Mendelssohn, Chopin, and Liszt, to whom he soon gave a pretty wide berth, he played others to whom he was to remain faithful for the rest of his life, such as Joseph Haydn and his late sonata in E-flat major. Beethoven's D major sonata, Opus 10, No. 3. The sonata No. 7 by Sergei Prokofiev. Johann Sebastian Bach's Italian Concerto. And the Toccata in E minor. Beethoven's Eroica Variations. And Paul Hindemith's Third Piano Sonata.